I don't hate people on the internet that I've never met, because, you know, that would be kind of weird. There you go. I guess it's maybe the perversion of the word. Kind of like the perversion of rage. I don't know if you guys have ever seen the definition of rage. I certainly hope so. Head over to the dictionary, find out what rage actually means. And then every time you say, oh, that guy is raging, then try and find out, try and figure it out in your mind. Like, does this actually fit the definition of rage? Because if it doesn't, it's probably not rage, to be fair. It's kind of the same as epic and fail. Those two words have lost their meaning as well. Which, once again, is kind of sad. Okay, I've got the second one out. This should work a little bit better this time, I hope. We're going for the Hellions again. I think this build order is a bit better. That should be up at about the time. Yep, I think the timing on that is actually pretty much perfect. And I actually have a supply depot in hand, which is wonderful. That means I can get things going much quicker. Close enough. Insufficient vesting gas. There we go. Spine crawler already down. Okay. That's fine. I don't have any scouting information, but I can definitely get it with the Hellions, and I can transition out for this. Mostly into airplay, primarily. Okay. Economy's fine. No, not a tech lab, you doofus. There we go. It's a shame I can't get the scouting information I actually wanted, but it's fine. At least we can take Zelnarg Watchtower. Keep things going on that front. Hellions on the way, yeah. Kill one more just to be safe. And we can go into another supply depot after that. And then once we go out with this initial little Hellion push, we'll look to expand behind it, I guess. That sounds fair enough, I think. Oh, he is really wanting to hold on to that scouting information, isn't he? That's actually kind of unfortunate. Looks like I'm going to have to scan for it. Okay, then. I accept my fate in that regard. Evolution chamber. Spore crawler at the back. I am not going Banshee, so there you go. Good, that's a waste. That's excellent. That's exactly what I want him to do. I.e. build things that are of no use to him. He's actually in close air. I'm very surprised he hasn't sent an overlord over yet. Go check for it. Get that going, yep. That's fine. All is okay. All is wonderful for the moment. Why would he not send an overlord? I don't know, actually. I really don't. Like, you'd think that in close air, you'd surely send one. Maybe send one earlier and I just wasn't paying attention, I guess. Maybe. I have so much gas right now. That's going to have to be something that I deal with. Okay. My unit count is looking fairly strong. Should hopefully be enough to do some pretty silly damage. Admittedly, he will see this coming, but he's only going to get a few seconds additional warning by it. I'm hoping he hasn't got roaches on the field, because if he has, then I'm in big trouble. Let's get the tech lab on there, and we need to look into expanding. Got a few more Hellions on the way. Sort the expansion out in a minute. Barbecue time! That's not enough, I'm afraid. Let's have a look at the back of your... You don't have anything there. Okay, so he's... Oh, it's a mass queen block. Right, okay. Yep, that works. That definitely works. Okay, so I have a bit of map control right now, so we can play around with that just a little bit. He's walled off against queens. Well, with queens, even. Which is pretty sensible. The problem is that he's actually still denying scouting to me. So he's got Lair on the way. Right. Okay, so I'll have maybe another run in with Squad 1. He's got nothing in there. I mean, this expansion serves no practical purpose. But of course he'll just wreck my Hellions. Okay, so let's transition out of that. Into something that'll actually work. There's really no point in me throwing all of that stuff away. Get Stim on the way. A couple more barracks definitely wouldn't go amiss, I feel. No. Absolutely not. Jesus. There are every now and again I find tracks on this playlist that are absolutely abysmal. That being one of them. It's like, not really a fan of the call stuff. So, he really hasn't built anything. I mean, he's just gone mass queen. He's going for lair, so could be going for roach play with speed. Could, of course, be going for other wonderful things like mutalisk, so we've got to prepare for that. Okay, yep. More tanks. try and prevent the scout as much as possible. He'll probably see that tank. Go on, kill it. Okay, so he doesn't see the tank, but he probably knows about it anyway.
This better be good.
Okay, let's start rolling out right here. Get things moving on the tank front. Got the one back. What was that? I need to know what that was in the corner. A couple of Zerglings. Okay. More tanks on the way. Gonna have to do something to actually clean this area out, aren't I?
Speak up! Fueled up, ready to go!
Oh, it's on. Bad enough.
Head on. Complete.
Deployment off. That's a lot of Zerglings. Yeah, I wasn't thinking this one through, was I? Not exactly. No, that was actually really stupid. That was a complete freaking waste, in fact. Don't know why I did that. Seems kind of dumb. Well, we need to prep against muters. Which I'm almost certain are coming.
Research complete.
These units down here, get the tank off in the corner. Clean that out, yep. Ah, can we at least lower that so we can get the tanks down at the bottom of the damn ridge? Okay, yep, good, good, good. More tanks. Uh-huh. Transfer, please. There you go.
Insufficient rescue.
Marine shield would be good. Get some marines out. Okay, I've got more tanks this time. Get the spares transferring down there. Leave one there just to cover this area.
You got it.
His creep spread is fairly impressive from him. He may have even got a third as well.
This better be good.
Not enough energy.
Supply is going to be a problem. Sort that out.
Additional supply depots required. Additional supply depots required.
Those are muters, aren't they? Do I have enough missile turrets? Yes, we're about to find out. If that missile turret goes down, I'm in serious trouble. Oh, God. Why did I not build more than that? Someone explain this to me. Is there an explanation why I didn't build more than that? Because I'm about to lose now. Why am I such a spaz? Somebody could answer that one for me. That'll be awesome, because look at that. It's completely exposed now. I also have barely any marines with me here. My deployment wasn't even at the right time by the looks of it. Never mind, maybe it wasn't. And here come the muters that I have no defense against, because I'm an idiot. Okay. Get more going up right here. Get the saturation sorted out. I'm not mining gas. No, don't build turrets on there, good lord. So this area is pretty much covered. I need Thors. Already have an economic disadvantage. I'm throwing units away and doing nothing to them.
Gas.
What the hell's up with my gas count? Come on. What's up with my gas count is I don't freaking have any. More muters. Wonderful. Did I build anything to stop them? No, of course not. We don't need anything to stop them. Why did I not build units? Why is that? What am I even doing in this game? I am really confused. I thought I'd built missile turrets. No, you hadn't built missile turrets. Oh, okay. Well, that's kind of unfortunate. I am so boned in this game already. He'll have expanded there. Probably even taken another if he's got any damn sense. I have no upgrades. My economy's a mess. I haven't got plus frickin' one yet. And I've even got 4 SCVs in there. Why? Who the hell knows? Need to get Thors. Still need Marines and Marauders on the ground, admittedly, but I need to get Thors. Did I get the armory finished? At least I got the armory finished.
We could use some help here.
Plenty of muters. Okay, I'm at least mining gas from there, so that's a start at any rate. Thors are going to be a problem until I get the gas for them. Working on it, at least. Look for plus one vehicle weapon. Right, I need more barracks. That's become abundantly clear. Yeah, I know, I'm queuing 2. I'll put a third there. Then go back to work after that. Some orders. Supply count is getting kind of low. Deal with that. More fours. He's not going up missile towers to cover this. I wasted so much money doing it, though. That's the thing that bothers me more. And on there. Let's build marines. Gas count is still looking a little shoddy, to say the least. I have no idea what he's got. He's going high, for God's sake, and he's got infestors. And upgrades. And loads of units. And I also have no medevacs or Vikings. Wasn't really thinking that one through, was I? Let's get a couple of those down. Just once we get the Thors out, I can do some kind of push. Where are the Thors, anyway? Did they get stuck? Of course they did. Christ. They get stuck on that add-on, I think. More Thors. Second engineering bay. And let's try and get another expo going. I surely have enough missile turrets. Maybe not, actually. I don't know, I do have a lot. Where are those Thors? Nowhere useful? Of course not. Well, I haven't expanded there yet. Oh yes, of course, they're still around there, aren't they?
Additional supply depots.
Thors, go.
In the rear, with the gear.
Back to work after that. Expo's on its way. Coming down.
Orders received.
Look at this creep spread as well. I need a raven. Is it... Can you still not get out of there? Oh, man. Apparently not.
Insufficient Vespine gas.
Get me back into the fight!
It's the tanks now, isn't it? Of course. Of course it's the bloody tanks. Get them over there. Can the Thors get out of my base now? Because that would be great. I know it's a little bit crazy. I get a raven going.
Complete.
Better be good.
Add-on complete.
He's going to see me coming a mile away unless I start clearing this out. Let's at least get the tanks forward just a little bit. Try and take the gold. Secure this area. Get a raven out. Otherwise, get some medevacs out. I don't exactly have a large number of these bloody things.
Four.
I still am kind of terrified about what this guy's going to end up doing to me. If I'm honest. Just can get the Raven out. Hell, could even get a missile turret down there to start spotting things. Sure, we're good on that front. Now what? That's fine. It's not a problem by the looks of it. Missile turret coming up right there. At least it's going to be fairly difficult to break this line. It'll be tricky, certainly. Get more tanks going. Got the expansion here. Planetary fortress right now. Spares, off you go. Last meals. And saturate this area as much as possible. Keep the defenses going on that one. Raven is out, so let's make use of that. You are creep clearing squad. Off you go. That is your sole purpose in this life. Clear that creep. That's a doom drop, isn't it? Oh dear. Didn't see that one coming. I have a feeling we might have to attack. Because I don't really have anything else I can do. Everything is going to get gutted. Unless I can get a deployment off here. Actually, the damage done there was fairly minimal. Thank God. Kill this. There we go. Let's stop those broodlords. Kill his baneling nest. This is actually kind of a stompy force I've got going on right here. Liking it. I don't know if it's a stompy enough force, though. Why don't you actually shoot at what we need you to shoot at? There we go. I'm holding for the moment. second wave coming in right here. Massive fungal growth, goddamn. I had mules, didn't I? Yeah, I did. We'll get some repairs going on right now. I don't know if I've quite got the unit count I need to do big damage right here. You did also just throw away an absolute metric ton of units. Fours are just barely holding up here, right? Repairs are actually keeping them going, oddly enough. Shame we can't get a scan over there. Reinforcements are on the way.
Not enough energy.
A few more SCVs down there to fix the Thors up would be amazing. Upgrade-wise, level 1 vehicle plating. Still not looking so great on the resource count.
Not enough minerals.
Transfer from there would definitely help matters. On third base. Can the Thors hold it? What's the point? They probably can. Repairs coming in quite nicely. Kill the statue because, you know what, I don't like it. Simple as that. It's a mass line of... We've cleared out this area. Can we go around here? Let's see if Festa melted. Bungle actually missed. I don't know if I actually have enough Thors to beat this many roaches, though. I don't think I do. He has way more bases than I do. Kind of unfortunate. Okay, we're gonna have to pull back. Just Marines and Marauders coming in at the moment. And I don't even have level 2 upgrade on them. The Thors did a good job, but they weren't quite good enough. Also, wasn't that building units? Yes. I do have a tank down there, but I'm still on 3 bases, and God knows how many he's on. Also, I neglected to build more missile turrets right there. It's definitely worth doing. Yes, it's because I randomly sent you over there.
Ready for pickup?
Which is pretty stupid of me.
Inbound.
A couple of muters over there. If that's coming back on. Middle count is not as good as I would like. I do need to expand again when I get the chance. I haven't actually... No, we haven't emptied those gas, so... We could get 3 SCVs in there. Gas count in there is looking okay. Transferred pretty much everything off that line. So I'm thinking we do need another expo. Need another expo a while ago, honestly.
Now life's here.
Yeah, I'm still thinking I'm probably in big trouble. And the reason behind that is that he will have way more bases than I do, and I've been unable up to this point to really strike at them properly. Did I get another engineering bay down? I did, so let's at least try and catch up on upgrades. Mostly roaches. Wow. That's ultras as well. Okay. Yeah, wasn't quite expecting that. Holding this could be tricky, to say the least. Keep the damn repairs going. Keep that planetary fortress up. Yeah, that's... I don't think I'm going to get away from this, honestly. Ultras are difficult to deal with. Especially when they're 3-2. Yeah, that's me done. GG. Out macroed and outplayed. Yeah, I was dead like 20 minutes ago, honestly. It's kind of a shame. Maybe if I'd brought tanks along with that last push, I might have been able to break his natural, but still. He no doubt would have had more bases. I didn't do any harassment, so it's my own fault. Nobody to blame but myself. Okay, next one will be against Protoss. Here we go. Yeah, there's all sorts of things I could have done. But there you go. It happens. My late game is very weak. I don't deal well with the macro. That Zerg was better at it than me. He had more money and had better resources. He was also ahead on upgrades. Protoss this time around. We'll see how this one turns out. By the way, those of you who do not know, the last player in the Invitational, which is happening on Sunday at 2 o'clock in the afternoon, British time, that's 3 p.m. Central European Summer Time, that will be 9 p.m. on the East, 9 a.m. in fact, on the East Coast of the U.S., the last player is Sho. The full lineup is available in the Team Liquid thread. If you head over to Team Liquid and you're looking at tournaments, you will find the Shoutcraft Invitational and all of the players therein. I will be casting that one live on this channel, and hopefully it should be really good. As I say, you guys managed to raise the money for that by watching the ads on this channel. Every commercial you watch has sponsored, in some small part, a tournament. So there you go. Thank you very much for that. It's very, very cool of you. Okay, you can bugger off for the time being. Thank you. No more nonsense. Awesome, fantastic, wonderful. Everything we always wanted in one tiny little base. Yes. So we'll be doing the same thing, which is a all-in, apparently, according to people who are worse than me. And to be fair, it takes quite a lot to be worse than me, so you should be honoured by that. We'll see how it turns out. Spladeeper coming down right there, straight into that. Built the Marine first, which is fine, nothing wrong with that. No point getting the Stim earlier. Let's say, if you end up getting... It's more of a point, if there's no point in getting the Tech Lab earlier, because you don't have the gas to get the Stim, so build the Marine first, unless you're going for some other crazy build that isn't quite the same as this. But yeah, it really comes down to when you're going for that Stim push, like, can I kill him? If I think so, yes, I am going to stay on one base. If I'm confident that I can break him, I will stay on one base, without question. Why wouldn't I? You know, I dedicate my resources to the attack. It's an aggressive strategy, and it works. If I don't think I'm going to break him, then I expand behind the push. Maybe go in for a second wave with plus one to suppress, try and contain him a little bit, and then go from there. But yeah, as I say, people use the word all-in far too much, and they don't really understand what it means. All in play does not mean that. Not by any stretch. I'd say the 3-rack stim timing push is very standard. You should also bear in mind that if you're trying to learn to play this game and you've only just gotten hold of it or whatever, don't be put off when people say, oh, it's an all-in, just use whatever strategy works for you, and you'll soon find out as you go through the leagues what works and what doesn't. And if all you're doing is, say, 6-pooling, then the chances are you won't get very far. So, that's fine. You will learn that. I have an objection to people saying, oh, well, you shouldn't do this strat, you shouldn't do this strat. It's like, you use whatever works, and if it doesn't work, then chances are that you use the wrong strategy. Grab that one. There we go. Marine out of that. Come on, give me more marauders. More delicious marauders. It's what we want. It's what we need. Okay, what's the timing like on that? I think I might be a little late on the conch shell, but nothing major. Get the engineering bay down. I think we should probably start the upgrade slightly earlier. We're going to have a supply problem momentarily. Okay, so we saw 2 gates, possibly a third. Certainly look like it. Could be 2-gate robo. Okay. 6. That's actually a really bad number. I think I screwed that up a little bit. Oh, there's another Marine hanging behind there, that's why. Go take that first. You know what, I think we'll actually just... Have we queued Marauders now? We're alright, okay. I just wanted to check that I wasn't screwing this up royally. Plus one, here we go. Okay. Right, so this will be the first wave. We'll see what kind of damage we can do with it. He doesn't have map control. We'll see if he's expanded. If he's expanded on 2 gates, which I don't know. I think it's 3-gate. What I can tell. It certainly seems to be. Supply. Come on. Basic, silly mistakes. He hasn't expoed yet. Can I scan the ramp? No. I'm going to poke off it. See what's going on. Zealots right there. thing we can't deal with fairly rapidly. What else is he building exactly?
Can't wait.
Where's the rest of his units? Is he warping in on my base or something? Wow, if I can actually shut down all these pylons here, he's going to be totally boned. Well, that's all of his production facilities. DTs? Oh, hi! DTs, alright, okay. That was interesting. Well, I shut down most of his production. That was supposedly a DT rush. But he hasn't got to my base yet. And I don't think he's warped them enough a proxy pylon either, by the looks of it. That was a surprise. Like, DTs! That's cute. Okay. Well, that's not a problem. Because the way you shut down DTs is to build a single missile turret. And that really is about it. And make sure you've got a scan for a cleanup on your next wave. So he's invested an awful lot into that. I'll have a second backup just in case. Oh, hi. DTs, yeah. I love free DTs. They're my favorite kind of DT. Okay. Got the Marines in there. Then everyone else can push out. And I do have what I need to do a scan, I believe. Yes, I do. Awesome. Right, well, I've got lots of money. I really should have expanded earlier, but hey. So we should be in a pretty good position. Shut down his pylons quite nicely. Another supply depot would be good, certainly. So he can't get through there. He will die if he tries. So we've got the scan ready. Shut down his DTs. Bit of damage done, but I'm alright with that. Oh, did I miss a DT? Apparently I did. Nice split by him then. Okay, that's actually going to be a real problem. Because that DT will be able to kill everything I've got. Just try and stay mobile. Kill that Stalker right there. Ah, these DTs are going to be kind of annoying. Right, well, I don't really have any way to mobile scan, but at least not without energy. Funny thing is, these DTs might actually hold. It's kind of a neat strat, really. It's like DT expand. Okay. Right. Well, we'll do what we can for the moment. My economy should have an edge on him. I do have expansion coming up right there. It's more of a case of make sure I get them on the scan. Second one coming down right there. As long as it doesn't drop them, I'll be fine. I'm going to put one of these in a mineral line just in case. Do not trust sneaky DTs. Oh no. Only a unit of 11 of them this time. I did get plus one attack. Factory is on the way. I'm looking to try and get a Raven out. If he continues with this silly strategy, which he very well might. Nothing saying that he won't. My expansion is late as well, which definitely didn't help. Do I see any DTs? I don't see any DTs, not yet anyway. Keep an eye out for them, they look fairly obvious. Usually. Okay. So we can wreck that expansion. I don't see any more DTs, maybe I killed them all. Okay, let's get that expansion denied. Send in additional units. We must construct additional units. We must kill all of his pylons. And all of his bases as well, that would be cool. DTs. Shut them down. Entirely sure I've got enough units for this. No, I should be alright. Got reinforcements on the way anyway, so it's not really a big deal. Okay, there we go. Right. Transfer. Might be a tad excessive on the transfer, but hey. Need to get a Raven out, because quite frankly, I'm sick of this nonsense. Well, I guess we're hanging down here for the moment. Keep getting the units going. Keep that in there just in case he does anything silly. And we should also try to go for plus two weapon. Yeah. And I'm going to keep this one spare for the moment. Make sure we've got scans. Shut that sentry down. Nah, we don't have damn visibility. Actually, no, we've got visibility on the pylon, so that helps. Okay, let's start shutting down some pylons. Oculus production. He does have a Colossus den, as I like to call it. But we're actually going to shut that down, because I don't like Colossus, and Colossus are unfriendly. Okay, that's all of his production shot phases. He seems angry. Apparently we're imbalanced because he decided to Dark Templar rush. What is it with all the Protoss these days? They're so very angry. I think it was the Fourgate nerf. You know, it's kind of like cutting off their own dick. You wouldn't be happy about that either. But yes, Dark Templar rush is not very effective against Terran. No, no, it is not. Certainly not when done that way. Oh well. Another Protoss win, another Platinum win. I can't really complain. I'll do one more. Terran so OP. Terran so OP. And the last game will be against Zerg. No TVTs today. How wonderful. Pretty awesome. Yeah, I'm okay with Zerg. You know, I don't mind losing to Zerg. Mutas kind of bother me, but there you go.
SCV ready.
Okay, we might go for the Hellion. Sounds like a plan. Or could we go for the Banshee? Banshee probably works better on this map, actually. Yeah, I'd say Banshee. Nobody expects the Banshee Inquisition. Nobody. It's a little early on that supply depot, but not a huge deal. It's just kind of pointless. Didn't serve any practical purpose. That's the main thing. Why would I build it so early? Now, Tal'Darim Altar does give me a chance of going for that really early gas, but it is dicey, and if he sees it, then he'll know exactly what's coming, so I think I'll just go with a slightly later Banshee on that basis.
Not enough minerals.
Go on, build
not
units. That's what you're here for,
not
dammit.
Minerals.
It's so horrible when your CC doesn't do its job. Not enough minerals, not enough minerals. Then find me the damn minerals. Build me an army worthy of Mordor. Get on it. Get on it.
SCV ready.
Today's been fairly successful. One loss, which was thoroughly well deserved, I might add. My own fault. Screwed it up.
SCV ready.
And two very angry Protoss players. I'd say, I think it comes down to the fact that Protoss are not feeling as imber as they used to. Which, of course, in my opinion, I'm a Terran, so they weren't Imber to begin with, but you get the idea. It's more down to the fact that the metagame shifted away from Protoss dominance, and apparently that Platinum players think that applies to them, which it actually doesn't. It's like, well, okay, so Protoss aren't winning as many major international tournaments. That means me, as a Platinum player, is affected by this. Not really, bro, not really. That's not quite how it works. This is going to be a fairly late Banshee, but it's at least an economically sound build. I don't need to go uber fast Banshee, oh my god. But no, no need. Get some Banshees a little bit later and play reactionary once again. I think that was probably the issue with me going early Hellion last time. The success I've had against Zerg lately is because I've been playing a very reactionary set of builds where I'm just like, right, okay, well, I basically go with 1-1-1 and I see what happens. Have I only got two guys in there? I really hope I've got more than two guys. Oh my god, you tard. No wonder. It's like, why exactly don't I have a lot of money? Oh yeah! Gas! That helps. Sometime in 2013, we might discover where the opposing player actually is. free drone! Yay, my favorite kind of drone. So he's definitely not over there, so if he sends an overlord, it's going to be coming from this direction. Let's make sure that that's all good. Certainly seems to be. How many have we gotten there? Once again, two. What is it with me? And you know, I like those automatic miners in the campaign. The noob miners, as I like to call them. The scrub miners. Let's get that one over here. Banshee is the strat for the time being. Get a Hellion out so they won't go amiss. That's not a Hellion, you idiot. There we go. One of those down. Span behind the Banshee pressure, which will come pretty late in the game, and God knows what he's building right now, because I haven't found him yet. Tell the Remolta! Good if you like a marathon. Zerglings moving across. Are they going Baneling or to the point? Well, let's get some Hellions out. Find out what is happening. Whoa! Early Baneling bust. Very early Baneling bust. Okay. Well, I'm not dead yet, but this is... No, actually, he's only attacking my barracks, so... As long as I get a Hellion out, I might... He's got Speedling, though, I don't know. This is going to be difficult one way or the other. Okay, I got a Hellion. And it's going to get surrounded. Come on. That was a really early Baneling bust. I couldn't even scout it out. He's going to find the sodding bastard. Well, there you go. I had no idea where he was. Took me ages to find him. And that was that. No scout. Oh well. Never mind. Kind of disappointing way to end things, but I have other things to do, I'm afraid. Thank you very much for watching the stream today. I will be back at some point tomorrow. And just remember that the usual scheduled stream on Sunday will be replaced by the Shoutcraft Invitational Tournament. All the information on that is over on teamliquid.net. Go to teamliquid.net and go to the forums section and then go to tournaments. And you will find the Shoutcraft Invitational. I'll see you next time.